We're down to the final four, featuring 56 players who have their name on the Stanley Cup, including the face of the game, Pittsburgh captain Sidney Crosby, and the game's most dominant defenseman, Boston captain Zdeno Chara. Sid, meet Zdeno. He'll be with you on a job shadow for the next 2 weeks. Through all of the ups and downs and the flat spots all season, Tuukka Rask has perhaps been Boston's most consistent player, and that's continued in the Stanley Cup playoffs. Some speculated Marc-Andre Fleury might return from exile in this series, but how can it be anybody but Thomas Vokoun in goal, 6-1 in the playoffs, and he's won 17 of his last 19 starts overall, including two against the Boston Bruins. A lot of star power on the ice, and Brad Watson and Chris Rooney will be the men who will officiate the first game of this Eastern Conference Final. Sidney Crosby, the former Team Canada teammate Patrice Bergeron, head-to-head to start the game. Bergeron with Brad Marchand and Jaromír Jágr, who started his career here in Pittsburgh. Johnny Boychuk is with Zdeno Chara to start on defense against Sidney Crosby's line with Pascal Dupuis and Chris Kunitz. Chris Letang with Mark Eaton. Dumps the puck in behind the net. Here's Crosby, a hard centering pass. Second chance, backhander, and Rask has to make his first save. Boychuk took a run at Kunitz, and the puck comes around on the boards, and Boston's hemmed in its own zone. Brad Marchand couldn't get out. Puck is snatched away, and along the boards, I thought an arm might go up there as Pascal Dupuis went down. Boston can't get out. Kunitz kept the puck to the end boards. Dupuis, Crosby, a deflection. Kunitz lost a handle on it in front. Off the heel of his stick, and he couldn't get the shot. And a big hit at center ice. Chris Letang on Brad Marchand. What a start. This is only the first minute. Pittsburgh back to the attack. There's Andrew Ferentz back in the lineup after missing a series with an injury. Here's Milan Lucic with David Krejci and Nathan Horton. Horton is in after the puck. He's checked. Puck's thrown up the boards, held into the blue line by McQuaid. Tyrone McGinley trying to come out with Evgeny Malkin and James Neal, and they get through center. McGinley on his off wing, stops up, looking for someone. Watched there by Dennis Seidenberg. And the puck is in the corner for Neal to go after. Lucic came back and got it first. Seidenberg paired on defense with Andrew Ferentz as the puck comes out to center. Heavy hitting early on, good pace, and everybody's getting into the action. With some speed, Tyler Kennedy, checked by Tyler Seguin. Ferentz is back for the puck. There's Adam McQuaid up the boards. Rich Peverly chops the puck along the boards, and Seguin starts out with Chris Kelly. Kelly snaps a shot, and Vokoun makes his first save. Rich Peverly, Seguin, and Kelly on a third line. It only has 5 points in the playoffs. McQuaid, here's Torrey Krug with a shot off a skate in front. McQuaid with a shot that just missed. Glove side. Krug trying to stand up at the blue line. He's a 22-year-old. 4 goals in 5 games. He's only played 7 NHL games, and he's in the Eastern Conference Final for Boston.
You can see what a week off does for both these teams. The energy is so great already. 2.5 minutes of continuous play with chances at both ends.
Now the fourth lines are on the ice, Craig, so everybody's been in action without a stop in play as the puck comes to the front of the net and to the blue line. Here's Matt Niskanen for Pittsburgh. You see Jokinen with Brendan Morrow and Craig Adams on the fourth line against Gregory Campbell's fourth line for Boston. Johnny Boychuk slows things down up the middle for Campbell, and he scooped the puck onto his own bench. Perilously close to over the glass and out of play. So 2:49 in, flat out start to the game, and everybody's been in action.
Well, feverish pace. You can see Chara going for the hit, didn't get the puck. A chance for Kunitz, he can't find the handle, and then this is not what you're expecting if you're Brad Marchand. You look up and you have Letang, put your head down, Letang steps up, and like Elliot Friedman was talking about, the Penguins trying to establish a physical play as well. But both these teams, with that rest, really a lot of energy to start the game.
With a faceoff in his own zone, here's where the match game starts. Patrice Bergeron is the best faceoff man in hockey, and he comes out to take the draw. Sidney Crosby looked back at the bench. They wondered if they might change, and then he comes to the faceoff circle, and they have a set play probably ready. Crosby around on the boards for Chris Letang. Brad Marchand checks him. Here's a 3-on-1 for Boston. Jaromír Jágr moves in to Bergeron. He missed the pass. What a chance for Boston against the Crosby line. Here comes Dupuis. His pass to Letang went off the stick. In behind the net, Crosby tried to relay that out front. Mark Eaton Johnny Boychuk stepped in, and Jaromir Jagr takes a pass from him, and the Bruins start out again. Brad Marchand, who picked up his pace in the last round against the Rangers, as did this whole line. Jagr for Marchand, that was tipped out of the air, a loose puck in front, is gathered in by Chris Letang, and he gets the puck to Crosby at center. Jumping up is Pascal Dupuis, and he takes the shot that's blocked, and the Bruins turn it back the other way in a hurry. Marchand out of gas, though, gets to center and dumps the puck in. Nathan Horton on the forecheck against Brooks Orpik and Paul Martin. There's Evgeny Malkin trying to leg to center. He's taken down to David Krejci. We'll get the game's first penalty. A trip on Evgeny Malkin, and Pittsburgh's vaunted power play goes to work early.
And Jim, the one thing the Penguins have been able to do is draw penalties. 46 opportunities they've had in 12 games, and there's the stick to the skate Krejci on Malkin, so an early chance here for the Penguins.
Chris Letang led the team in points last series, guys. You've got to be very careful when you're going to be aggressive, because Boston can hurt you. The key to the series for me is number 87. 22 games against Boston, 8 times he had 3 points or more. And he's rolling now.
Sidney Crosby leads this power play the best in the playoffs so far at 28%. James Neal has been red hot. He's the go-to guy on the right side. Chris Kunitz, Chris Letang, and Evgeny Malkin. Letang, watched by Chris Kelly. Out with Rich Peverly on the penalty kill. A centering pass. Kunitz couldn't get a great shot. And Zdeno Chara, the workhorse defenseman who's played an average of 29 minutes a game in the playoffs, clears the puck.
It'll be interesting to see the setup here with James Neal, the left-hander. A lot of those one-hand, one-time shots going through number 33.
There's Crosby to the front of the net. That's blocked by Chara and smothered by Tuukka Rask.
And you can see Sidney Crosby as he tries to get in on this power play without the face shield underneath to protect that jaw. And he said early on it was a little bit tentative in practice the first few times until he took an elbow from teammate Jussi Jokinen and realized that felt okay. In those face-off type areas here, be interesting to see how much physical contact there is from Bergeron to that jaw area of Crosby, accidentally on purpose.
This is a great game within the game, isn't it? Two of the best face-off men who've made themselves into the best face-off men in the league. Sidney Crosby and Patrice Bergeron. Malkin leads the power play to center. Crosby in on the right side, watched by Bergeron, threw the puck back. Here's Malkin. No shot there, so he plays the puck into James Neal. He's got some traffic in front. Spins away from Bergeron. One-timer is stopped by Tuukka Rask. As Chris Letang took the shot, and the crowd gathers for the first time in front of the Boston net.
There's the influence of Zdeno Chara there. Neal looking for something to get through to the net, either go down to Crosby or get a shot through, but with that 6'9 frame, instead goes up the other side. They get the one-timer through, then a Seidenberg sign. You can see Rask, Glenn, he didn't know where that rebound was, did he?
I'm exactly in line with the one-timer from Letang, and he didn't know where it was because of Morrow in front of the net. That's the one thing about Pittsburgh, whether it's Iginla on this shift or Morrow. There are guys in the lineup that aren't afraid to stand in front of the net and deal with Zdeno Chara.
Still 58 seconds to go in the David Krejci penalty. Crosby has Iginla on his right side now.
Sidney getting a little extra there. He tried to slash Peverly back.
Crosby got the draw. Matt Niskanen to Paul Martin, the defenseman on the second power play unit. You see Jokinen sets up on the right wing boards. Paul Martin. Jokinen walks in, trying to pass the deflected right to Rask. And he's a good catcher of the puck, and he stops play.
You see early on Sidney Crosby battling for his room. He's having a discussion about the faceoffs. We've much talked about. Crosby's been a great faceoff performer in the last couple of years. You look at his career, but against these Bruins, only 5 of those 22 games was he able to crack that 50% mark. And he's been grinding it out here early on with both Peverly and Bergeron on that left side.
All the other teams say that the Bruins are the best cheaters in the faceoff circle in the league, and that's part of the reason they're the best faceoff team. There's Crosby with a little tip through. Malkin moves in and shoots. Rask stops it. Rebounds knocked into the corner. Crosby was right there. And Rich Peverly gets to the puck and clears it down the ice. Crosby and Malkin have stayed for this entire power play. James Neal's back on. Malkin carries the puck up the middle. One on four. Backhander. Huge rebound. Crosby shoots. Stopped by Rask. It hit him, and he smothered it with 9 seconds to go in the Krejci penalty.
Boy, you are dealing with a whole lot here with regards to the Pittsburgh Penguins. This last rush, two of the greatest players in our game. Malkin won on the world. He gets a good chance. Rebound goes to the most dangerous player on the planet, Sidney Crosby. You can't let your guard down for a second. Both these guys will play almost every second of every power play, and they pretty much did there. Malkin's off the ice for a short period of time. Crosby the whole time.
Let your guard down. You better not fall down.
There's already a shot to that mouth area without the protection.
Scramble draw with Brandon Sutter up against Bergeron this time. Already Bergeron's taken a ton of faceoffs from the blue line. Martin late in the power play. His shot ricocheted wide. Krejci's back on. Pittsburgh 0 for 1 in the power play. They had 4 shots though, and have outshot the Bruins 5-2 early on. Most of the game has been played in this end of the rink. In the first 6 minutes plus, here's Milan Lucic. Stops up, feeds the trainer. Horton takes a shot. He just missed with a blistering shot. Milan Lucic tried to play the puck to the blue line. It was swept away, and Matt Cook dumps the puck in. Rask, seeing a change on the Pittsburgh bench, played the puck up quickly. Here's Krejci with Lucic. Coming up is Krug. His shot hit a leg in front of the goaltender, Thomas Vokoun. And Pittsburgh's able to clear the puck all the way down the ice. It hits the side of the net. Adam McQuaid is back, and there's an icing call against Pittsburgh.
Well, I mentioned early on, this Bruin team is not afraid to shoot the puck. They're a team that all year is second in the National Hockey League during the regular season in shots. First in the playoffs, Krejci threw a crowd back to Horton, and you could see that Vokoun had a little trouble picking that one up as it went through that little screen right by the glove and just narrowly wide.
Lively boards here too. The puck will come off them hard and all the way out into the slot very often. Chris Kelly, another excellent faceoff man, won that draw out of the scramble. He's got Sagan and Peverly with him. Adam McQuaid in off the blue line. He's got Tory Krug back on the left side. Here comes the rookie defenseman, slammed against the boards by Brendan Morrow. Coming off the bench, jumping to the puck is Tyler Kennedy. Jokinen's with him. There's the pass. What a play by McQuaid. Sweeping the puck into the corner with his stick. And the Penguins come up with the puck off the board. Jokinen's shot, a weak one, stopped by the blocker of Tuukka Rask. And the Penguins have the puck again. Tyler Kennedy can't control it, though. McQuaid around on the boards. Kennedy couldn't get it out. Chris Letang kept it in. McQuaid up the board. Sagan will start out. Chris Kelly, veteran Rich Peverly. He delays, waits for some help off the bench, and here comes Nathan Horton to dump the puck around on the boards. Zdeno Chara off the left point, puts the puck towards the net. It was blocked in front of the goal. Kept in by the Bruins. Krejci to the front of the net, just off the stick of Milan Lucic. And here comes Evgeny Malkin to Tyler Kennedy. Back in front of the net, nobody there in time. And the Bruins will come back the other way, 3-on-2. Krejci into the middle. Lucic off the wing. Krejci to the net. And there's a good stick by Brooks Orpik to poke the puck into the corner. Stretch pass. James Neal with the Ginla. Centering. Knocked away into the corner. Little too slow in developing. Back for the puck is Andrew Ferentz. What a pace early on in the game. A few stoppages, so not much of a match game.
Too much flow.
Here comes Ferentz. Here's David Krejci. He shoots, scores! Off the defenseman Martin in front of his goaltender. And the Boston Bruins strike first in Pittsburgh.
Well, amazing how this game just opened up. End-to-end chances, transition game. Watch the defensive effort by Seidenberg coming back. It's a stick in the way before Ginla can get there. And then it's transition at the other way. If you're going to give the Bruins the line, look at the backing off of Orpik and Martin. Now you got Martin down. That might have hit his foot and then gone through the pads. Glenn, you probably had a better angle there.
Well, the thing you expect as a goaltender, when a player lays down, he's got the bottom part of the net. I got to worry about what is north of the player. Eaton lays down, gets a piece of the puck, and it finds a way through. Krejci didn't get a goal in the last series.
starts this one off the right way.
Had a terrific first series against the Toronto Maple Leafs. He leads the playoffs in scoring, and he has the first goal of the game.
And if I'm the Bruins, it's the perfect start. That's just the third shot on goal on Volkoon, and it plants a little seed of doubt.
David Krejci at 8:23 in the first period. A wonderful start to the game overall, and especially for the Bruins on Hockey Night in Canada. Well, I'm sure there was no concern for these two about their teams being ready after a long layoff.
Let's have 8 days off before the next game, if this is the way the start's going to be. Wow, 13 hits in the first 9 minutes. It has been 8-5 for Pittsburgh, so the Big Bad Bruins have been physically handled a little bit by the Pittsburgh Penguins early, but it's not necessarily the hit from the body that counts. It's the hit off the skate of Eaton that leads to the first goal of hockey game for Boston.
Officially, Krejci from Horton and Ferentz at 8:23, and the Brewers coming offside.
Well, you could see the danger on that goal of backing into your own zone, and the Orpik-Martin tandem here got down. Martin was down. Look at the right skate of number 7, Paul Martin. It just ticks off him right there, and you could see Volkoon expecting it off his pad. And what a start on the road for the Boston Bruins. They've twice now hit that trailer. You saw Horton miss from that same area, and Krejci puts it in the back of the net.
Martin was forced to back up into his goaltender because Ferentz got in behind him.
Andrew Ferentz with an assist in his first game back.
Crosby line is on the ice once again, out against the Bergeron line and on the road. Claude Julien gets the matchup that he wants. Zdeno Chara playing with Johnny Boychuk against Crosby. And there's a penalty coming up here for interference. It'll be against Pittsburgh. And the Boston Bruins will get their first power play as Sidney Crosby goes off.
This is all about setting a tone for a long series. You said head-to-head how Bergeron and Crosby are going to be going after each other. Here's a play, standing still, and he gets just a little bit of the rear end in on a hip check. The problem was the puck was long gone. And one improvement for the Pittsburgh Penguins has been their penalty kill. 10% better in the playoffs than they have been in the regular season.
Hey, Boston actually has a power play in this year's playoffs. Second best. They've had so much trouble with it over the last couple of years that they've got 7 goals in these playoffs. Zdeno Chara. Jaromir Jagr with Lucic a handful in front as Jagr stick handles in. Plays the puck to David Krejci. There's the point man with Jagr. Bergeron in the slot. And a steal and an intercepted pass by veteran penalty killer Craig Adams, and he clears the puck.
What a great read by Adams, and you know, just an unnecessary risk for Krejci there. He had all kinds of time. No sense in trying to force one through.
Here's Lucic. Slips the check of Matt Cook. Paul Martin under pressure from Lucic. And Brooks Orpik got the puck to Cook, and he in turn got it out to center. Pascal Dupuy has a pair of shorthanded goals, and he got the puck deep this time and changes. 50 seconds have gone by in the Sidney Crosby penalty. Dennis Seidenberg had the puck get away from it. Chara comes back. Sagan, Horton out of the second power play unit along with Brad Marchand. Chara stays. Watched by Brandon Sutter. The big man gives the puck off at center ice, and in comes Sagan to stop and set up from the slot. Marchand, no shot there. Torrey Krug has come onto the second power play, and he's really helped this power play pick up its pace in the playoffs, but not on this particular one with half a minute to go in the penalty. Krug will carry the puck to center. Seidenberg is partner. Watched by Mark Eaton. Dumps the puck in. Lucic in after it. But Orpik's able to clear it because Volkoon gave him the puck. One last rush for the power play as Krug gets the puck deep. Lucic can't get to it. Dupuy does, and he clears the puck the length of the ice. And that'll just about do it in Crosby's penalty.
That might be good timing for the Pittsburgh Penguins. The crowd's back into it after that goal against a good kill. Now a very important shift. You'll probably see Crosby and Malkin together.
Breakaway pass for Crosby. Didn't connect. Here's Crosby off the wing. Takes the shot. missed as he tried to go high glove side. Niskanen on the other side. Martin fires. Rask makes the save and he smothers the puck. A good penalty kill for Pittsburgh. Sidney Crosby with a chance up the middle, but he tripped over the blue line on hockey night. It looked like Sid would have a great chance coming out of the penalty box, but I think at the end of this, Craig, he collapsed in disbelief that he didn't get the puck.
Yeah, he came out of the box, and it looked like he was going to go off and then went up the gut and missed that. But then watch here. He thought he should have had a penalty against. Chirping at the referee. Didn't like the non-call there.
Evgeny Malkin intercepted the pass. He was going the other direction. He probably just didn't see Crosby there. Thought the pass was for him. There's Brad Marchand hustling to the puck. He tried a little chip shot with a backhand. Good burst of speed from Marchand. And he got himself a scoring chance. Turnover. Bruins keep the puck in. Jágr can't get the shot. He was checked by James Neal. Bergeron off the boards. Pittsburgh with a little trouble coming out of their own zone. Marchand with another steal. Blocked and he continues on against Letang. Letang recovers, checks Marchand off the boards. Neal is hit by Dennis Seidenberg and the puck comes to Iginla. Malkin to the net. And there's going to be a penalty on the play as his hands were hooked. Boy, there could have been several penalties on that shift, but the only one will be against Patrice Bergeron, back-checking on Malkin.
Well, I think the Penguin bench would be saying, how about Jágr? Jágr should have had one, too. He was hooking him all the way up. Good job by Iginla, keeping his legs moving to the outside. Look at it in the middle. You got two guys, Jágr first, and then the call was finally made there at the end. But you be the judge. Just a little bit of roping all the way down.
Two guys hooking him, not one. You get them both.
Darn close to a penalty shot.
And the big thing here is the face-off wizard, Bergeron, sits in the box. He's 6-2 tonight on the draws. That is going to hurt Boston on this kill.
So Chris Kelly on the first penalty killing unit now, charged to win the draw against Sidney Crosby, who's out with Kunitz. UC Jokinen over on the right side. Paul Martin back on the blue line, and James Neal on this power play. Malkin had just had a long shift.
And they were trying to get Niskanen out there too, but the refs wouldn't let them. Now Neal's on the point.
Jokinen off the boards. Martin with a shot, blocked in front of the net. James Neal hooks the puck in. Because of that long shift, Martin went up the ladder and kept that in. Nice play. Crosby centering. Kelly blocked it. Crosby got it again. James Neal shoots. Nowhere to go. Missed the net. Back to the blue line again. Paul Martin. James Neal. In an unusual position for him. Here's Martin. Straight away. Kelly doesn't have a stick. James Neal trying to take advantage of that. There's the shot from the point. Missed the net. Just nowhere to shoot. Crosby across the ice. Neal with a quick shot. That was blocked by Dennis Seidenberg. Neal again centering. A relay for Crosby by Jokinen. And it's taken away and intercepted and feared by Peverly. And a quick change by the penalty killers. A minute gone in the penalty.
What a key stick by Zdeno Chara there. That was a one-time shot waiting to happen for Crosby. And as you saw, the broken stick on the ice. A much-needed change for Kelly, who had given his stick to Seidenberg.
Boychuk gets back. Kaye can't get the puck out. Malkin refreshed and back in the game. Letang with a hard pass over to Niskanen. His shot stopped by Rask. Rebound cleared quickly by Gregory Campbell. Penalty killers change up again. And the faceoff doesn't become an issue with Bergeron off because there hasn't been one since the penalty started. And there might not be one as Marchand sends the puck the other way. David Krejci drives wide, puts on the brakes, kills some time. Ragging the puck, played it back into his own zone. Seidenberg, long shot all the way down the ice. 5 seconds from the end of the penalty to Patrice Bergeron. One shot on goal as the Bruins clogged up the front of the net. And it's Sutter, Tyler Kennedy shoots, missed up high. And the puck comes all the way back down into the Pittsburgh zone. And the teams are 5-on-5 again. 1-0 Boston leads on a David Krejci goal that deflected in off defenseman Paul Martin. There's Brandon Sutter off the wing, takes the shot, rebound, and another save by Tuukka Rask as Tyler Kennedy followed Brandon Sutter to the net. Shots are 9-5 now in favor of the Penguins. Latest shot, Brandon Sutter, and a rebound for Tyler Kennedy. Rask stopped that too.
two historical moments that Pittsburgh recalls much more fondly than does Boston in our Subway restaurant's bio. October 11th, 84, Mario Lemieux on the first shift of his career broke in on Pete Peters and scored on the first shot of his career. So that's how one of the two greatest players in Penguins history began. 21 years later, the Penguins' next franchise player scored his first goal on Boston. October 8th, 05, Sidney Crosby took a swipe at his own rebound, beat Hanno Toivonen. Jim.
Here's Milan Lucic for Boston, leading 1-0. Took a shot off the stick of Butch Orpik. Douglas Murray is back. There's a deflection off the boards of Tyler Kinnon. Rips through the neutral zone, chips the puck on Tory Krug, threw it at the net, and it took a goofy bounce and ended up in the corner over top of Tuukka Rask. It looked like he saw it all the way. There's Krug, Nathan Horton with Krejci and Lucic. Lucic runs into Brooks Orpik. And another stretch pass just missed Pascal Dupuis as the Crosby line starts to come on. Johnny Boychuk to center. Zone, zone, Matt Niskanen. Paired with Mark Eaton, moved the puck ahead, but he turned it over. Brad Marchand trying to get away, coming back in. Kunitz catches him, can't check him, he stumbled. And Marchand plays the puck to Ferentz. On the other side, Boychuk tipped by Bergeron. Jágr trying to get a hold of the puck off the seat of his pants. And back to get it is Pascal Dupuis. Martin, another turnover in the neutral zone by Pittsburgh's defense. Here's Jágr with a shot. Rebound, he shoots that again. And Thomas Volkoon made the save both times as Jaromír Jágr hears the boos in his old hometown.
Well, I used to love him here as a member of the Penguins, two-time champ, but you saw the frustration. Hasn't scored in 14 games, hasn't had a point in five of this playoffs, but he does a nice job following up the rebound, and what an effort by Volkoon to get across and make sure he got it.
200 feet away, though. Let's look at the good sticks by the Boston Bruins. McQuaid, good stick. Ferentz, not the biggest guy, so he has a good stick. Krug, he'll play with a good stick. You've got to be smart when you play against Pittsburgh.
And Chara plays with a long stick, and his shot just got up high on Mark Eaton and hurt him. A one-timer from Zdeno Chara, and that's Mark Eaton doubled over. Looks like he got hit in the face.
Not near the velocity, obviously, of the one that hit Sidney Crosby and knocked his teeth out, but this is just a quick release. Once again, the points open. There's the deflection. So it wasn't the velocity because it was tipped in front right there and then off of the chin. That high deflection by Peverley and Eaton, who's been a nice addition. He took over for Englund and has played a pretty solid role on the back end.
Looks like he's none the worse for wear right now.
Deflection takes all of the velocity out of that shot.
Yeah, it doesn't hurt at all.
Yeah.
Can't hear out of that ear.
Exactly.
Other than that, he's fine. Got two of them.
Beverly, Sagan, and Kelly working for the Bruins in the attacking zone against the Malkin line. Through the middle of the ice, here's James Neal. Evgeny Malkin to Akinla, kicked the puck up and couldn't get the shot. Another good Bruin stick. Letang, Brooks Orpik. That was blocked by Tyler Seguin and he lofts the puck to center. Kelly was held up and there's going to be an interference penalty. Chris Kelly might have got to that puck. He was held up by Brooks Orpik, who's complaining about it but heading for the penalty box.
Yeah, Orpik doesn't like it at all. This happened so quickly. For a second, Orpik thought he would be able to get the puck. And this is almost what I would consider coincidental contact. Orpik trying to watch it now. But watch who's hitting who. A nice job of Kelly coming in and making some contact with Orpik. And it happened a split second. And the call was made.
Arm goes out. It's the right call. But to me, Orpik can't jump.
Should have had that one on the rebound, you say?
I would agree.
Boston's on the power play for the second time in the game, 0 for 1, and leading in the game 1-0. Zdeno Chara. Bad pass, and Lucic couldn't get it, so Chara has to go back and get the puck again.
You think of the importance of the power play. You just know with this Pittsburgh team, you're going to have to score some goals. And when you got a chance early on to get this crowd out of it, get another late goal, they need the intensity level to pick up here on the power play.
Lucic, Bergeron. Now back to the blue line, Bergeron to Zdeno Chara. Been pressured by Dupuis, but he couldn't get the puck. Jaromir Jagr centering. Krejci shoots. Missed up high, short side.
That's a tough play. What a great pass by Jagr.
Pascal Dupuis, shorthand, and Brandon Sutter with a tip right on, and a nice save by Rask. Quickly back out to center. Nathan Horton stops up and feeds the puck in for Brad Marchand. Tyler Seguin's come out with him on the second power play unit. Seguin's centering pass. Swept away by Matt Cook, but he couldn't clear the puck. Krug kept it into the line, and over and back at the line, and the play's offside with 43 seconds left in the Orpik penalty.
I'm saying, Jim, this is one where Krejci usually would be on the side that Jagr was, making the pass to Jagr. Instead, they were flip-flopped, and that made it a tough play for Krejci. Jagr, like he's done so well, finds the seam. He finds himself on his off wing, slides it across, but you can see how long it took for Krejci to make any kind of a play. And then how about this for a deflection? Almost up under the arm and back in for a shorthanded goal.
Too much time to think. You've got almost too many options for you. And that was a lot of time to think about what he wanted to do with the puck.
Thought at first he wanted to switch hands.
Yeah, if I was a lefty there, it would be okay.
Dennis Seidenberg. Torrey Krug dashes up the middle for Boston. 22-year-old from Livonia, Michigan, passes off. Tyler Seguin dangling in behind the net. Passes back. Here's Horton with a one-timer, deflected, and just about worked for him. His initial shot wasn't a good one, but it almost deflected in.
Yeah, you saw the Krug again, the confidence he has with the puck. I like the fact that Claude Julien put him in the lineup here. Hard to take him out after the five games he played last series.
He really gets pucks through to the net, which is something Boston doesn't really have on their back end. You get the big shot in Chara, but this is a kid who just finds ways. Look at the Rangers, the way they block shots, and he found ways to get pucks through.
His challenge will be in this end of the ring, where Johnny Boychuk is right now for the Bruins. Penguins trying to attack. Sidney Crosby to Matt Niskanen. Screen shot blocked by the screen. Henry Campbell takes a hit. Couldn't make the play up the boards. Malkin taking a shift here with Crosby and Kunitz late in the period. Centering pass, no problem there. Puck is knocked down. Chris Kelly couldn't quite clear it. Here's a chance for Niskanen. Fires a shot just wide of the net. Lively bounce, backhander right on the goal line. Barely stayed out of the net as Evgeny Malkin took the carom off the boards. And the first period comes to an end with Malkin showing frustration that he didn't tie the game.
He can't believe that this didn't find a way to the back of the net. Tuukka Rask off the Lively boards, as you mentioned, Jim. Watch the backhander just under the arm and slid right across. And somehow Rask didn't knock it in himself, right down his pad just off the post.
Right along the goal line. And out. So it's still 1-0 for the Boston Bruins through a period and a great first game of the Eastern Conference Final. Don Cherry, Ron McLean, Coach's Corner coming up. David Krejci has the only goal of the Eastern Conference Final so far.
Back at the CONSOL Energy Center in Pittsburgh, Boston leading 1-0 to start the second period of Game 1. Reminder of Hockey Night in Canada's second screen. You can use your device to take part in trivia, polls, and games, interact, compete for cash prizes. You can be part of our broadcast. Engage at cbcsports.ca/second screen. Bruins killed a penalty, scored shortly after, so nothing to dislike there, but the Penguins had too many chances for Boston's liking. Assistant coach Doug Jarvis says the message the Boston players got between periods was to manage the puck better in Pittsburgh's zone, spend more time there, and to take some of the pressure off Tuukka Rask. Jim?
Excellent first period of this series, and we start the second period with the same matchup. Patrice Bergeron against Sidney Crosby. And here comes Jaromir Jagr into the attacking zone. Can't get the shot, and Crosby's quickly back the other way on Andrew Ferentz. Kunitz is with him, driving the net. Trailer is Dupuis, and he had to stop to get the puck. For Crosby, Dupuis's gone to the front of the net. The centering pass comes to Mark Eaton. Along the boards, a quick shot by Kunitz. Steered aside by Tuukka Rask, and the second period starts the way the first period ended. Here's Brad Marchand, drop pass, Jagr shoots. Steered aside by Thomas Vokoun. Johnny Boychuk with a pinch, held the puck in for Jagr. Crosby back defensively. Pascal Dupuis. Teammates are starting a change. At least Kunitz is leaving. Chara's on there against Dupuis. Bumps him hard along the boards. Matt Cook fired the shot wide of the net. In comes Paul Martin. And he turned along the boards against Brad Marchand and just held the puck in. Chara with lots of time to move it up. David Krejci in the midst of a change. Jágr is still there with him as he dumps the puck in, and Jágr peels off the change. Krejci alone on the forecheck. And he just about stole the puck away from Paul Martin. Beverly held it in for a moment. A couple of quick passes, and Tyler Seguin dumps the puck back into the corner. Beverly and Martin battle. Tyler Kennedy up the middle. There's Matt Cook with Brandon Sutter. Back to Cook, and he'll chip and chase. Adam McQuaid is the first one back for Boston. Slammed against the boards and hurt by Matt Cook. And that draws a crowd as Chris Kelly comes right in after Cook. It's McQuaid just picks himself up to his knees after a hard, hard hit on a forecheck by Cook.
Well, there's no question that this one's a penalty. The question will be, how much is it? Just a 2 minute? As McQuaid, a little dizzy getting up there. And coming into this series, lots of different storylines. Obviously, Matt Cook's is a big one with the history he has with the Boston Bruins, and Mark Savard, the hit that basically ended his career here early on after some good pressure. This is just simply too much time. You could see the numbers. You could see McQuaid was ready to make the play, and there's just no question about that. And Cook's going to be gone for five, it looks like.
That's Chris Rooney signaling to the benches that it is a major penalty to Matt Cook as he goes to the dressing room. And a huge opportunity for Boston to bust this open as Cook hits McQuaid on the numbers.
And there's just no reason for it. I mean, it was a simple play that I know in super slow-mo looks like it takes forever, but when you saw it live too, the numbers were right there for Cook to make a decision, and he makes the wrong one.
We'll have 2 minutes of 4-on-4. As Kelly's taken the extra penalty, so.
And you know on the Boston bench, they're okay with that, right?
Yeah, they take the 3 extra minutes of an extra guy. The one thing, you know, you look at that Cook line with Sutter on it, they want to make the minutes hard when they play against Chara. Now, Chara was just on the shift before. As soon as the Cook line came on, he changed. So they have it in their mindset. We're going to go at these defense hard. They did, and they went over the line. Cook's going to serve the time.
Major for boarding to Matt Cook. Chris Kelly gets 2 minutes for roughing. Colin Campbell here as a fan, not as an adjudicator tonight. Son Gregory playing for the Boston Bruins. Tyler Kennedy over to serve Matt Cook's penalty. So 4-on-4 for a couple of minutes here, and a false start off the faceoff.
This is a really important 2 minutes for the Pittsburgh Penguins here. The puck never hit the ice. That's why the whistle went. On the drop of the puck, it hit the stick of Malkin. But right now for Pittsburgh, they need some offense. They got to make sure that this game doesn't suddenly get away from them, knowing that 3-minute power play is at the end of this too.
So not only does Pittsburgh lose Matt Cook, who's a pretty good penalty killer, on the penalty, but he's done for the night. And he's been a very good playoff performer up until now. Here's a steal. Evgeny Malkin off the wing. Little back pass, and Brooks Orpik has to stop. Creative idea. Orpik had to stop and get the puck. Malkin side of the net, tries to work his way out. Doesn't. Dennis Seidenberg hit him. And the fans, already incensed, are even angrier now. Here's Malkin again. He missed as he turned to protect the puck. Chris Letang. Lucic checks him. Dennis Seidenberg. Lucic run out by James Neal and knocked down.
There aren't many players that can win a physical battle with Malkin, but that was a good matchup with Seidenberg, and Seidenberg handled it well defensively.
Still 4-on-4. Here's Brooks Orpik. Threw the puck in front of the net, and Gillen was tied up by Ferentz. Bergeron against Letang, and Bergeron won the battle and got the puck to center. Sidney Crosby to Jerome Iginla and back. Crosby gets around Bergeron, but Bergeron recovered nicely to poke the puck away off the stick of Crosby. A battle behind the net. Jágr comes back to get the puck. bounces it up the boards. Bergeron makes sure the puck gets to center. In half a minute, the Penguins will be shorthanded. Ferentz up the boards. Jágr got to the puck. Niskanen's in some trouble trying to get back. Bergeron to Jágr. No trailer on the play as a third man, so Jágr just gets the puck to the inboards. Bergeron around to Tory Krug. Little give and go. Here's Krug. Can't quite get open for a shot. Threw the puck to the side of the net, and Volkoun is down on top of it.
Well, with 5 seconds left on the four-on-four, this was the best chance for the Penguins. Malkin wants the puck down low. Good stick first by Seifert, but then body on body to take away Malkin's chance.
We are not 3 minutes into the second period, and this is the 19th hit of the game by the Pittsburgh Penguins. And we saw the hit earlier, Matt Cook, but take a look. McQuaid looks over his left shoulder. He knows Cook, and they're off to his right. He knows Cook is coming. Players have to, I know you don't want to see guys getting hit in the numbers, but he knows it's coming. Don't turn into the boards. It's like trying to park a car driving 80 miles an hour to the parking spot. Get the player on your hip. Ride him into the boards. That's a defenseman's responsibility. Not like he was surprised by the hit.
Dying seconds of the four on four, Glenn, and now out of the penalty box comes Chris Kelly. Boston's on a power play, and they have 3 minutes with which to work. They're 0 for 2 with a man advantage so far in the game, leading one to nothing. Now they get the right personnel on the ice. Tyler Seguin took the puck from Krug and dumped it in. He's on the fly against Douglas Murray and lost his stick. And that's advantage Penguins, and up comes Pascal Dupuis. Greg Adams with him. Goes after the shooting. Make sure he keeps the puck deep, and the Bruins hemmed in their own zone. A bouncing puck falls to the side of the net. Dupuis desperately trying to get a shot. He's taken down. And the fans call another penalty that the referees won't. Here's Tory Krug weaving into the attacking zone. Put the puck off the glass and it hit the netting, so the play is stopped.
This guy's going to be an unrestricted free agent at the end of the year. Pretty much does it all. Plays with Sidney Crosby, kills penalties. Look at the effort level, the compete level, just to try to get a chance. And then gets interrupted by Bergeron. Doesn't stop to complain. It's 100 miles an hour back down the other way. He's going to have a very good summer and a wealthy fall.
Bergeron, Lucic, Krejci up front of the power play. Chara and Jágr on the points right now, and Lucic just got to come in and take a draw. And he won it. Zdeno Chara, David Krejci as the Bruins power play sets up. Lucic is in front. Jágr from the right point down to Lucic, who kicked off the front of the net. Jágr watched by Brendan Morrow. Trying to draw a defender to him. Chara on the other side. Krejci shot off the side of the net. Lucic. Jágr. Broken up by Letang, but he can't get control. Now Brendan Morrow chopping at the puck. Can't get it out. Chara held it in. Lucic trying to feed Jágr. Letang broke it up. Chara got the puck though on the other side. Krejci stopped by Volkoun.
Well, one thing that Lucic on a power play is going to do is park himself in front of the goaltender, try to mirror the pass. He's there for support. As soon as it goes up top, tries to mirror the pass. Watch him slide across. Excellent job of Volkoun following him and getting a hold of it. But this shot here, just way too far on the outside of that dot. An easy time for Volkoun to track not only the pass and then easily handle that shot.
Seguin wins the draw. Bruins have been dominant on the dot. Seidenberg, Tory Krug. There's a quick shot by Seguin. A loose puck in front of the net. Dupuis cleared it away. Here's Krug. Seguin out of the corner. Krug. Seguin with Nathan Horton right there. Brad Marchand in front of the net. And the puck was knocked out of the air by a high stick, so the play is stopped, and the faceoff will come all the way down into the Boston zone.
And on the power play, if you knock it down with a high stick, it goes back in, and just a little bit of impatience here. Instead of allowing it to come down, reaches out for it, and that's a big mistake. Now a defensive zone faceoff for the Bruins. The one thing they can do, though, unlike an icing, is they can change.
Well, the one thing that Pittsburgh can't do in this game is win a faceoff. Boston has won 70% of the draws. The only advantage is it's 200 feet from their net, so no harm, no foul if they lose it, like there.
Bergeron one another from Crosby.
Easily, too. I mean, you just got to not lose clear. At least try to fight for it in their feet.
They got to get some bigger wins.
Yeah, got to get some help. Go for a tie.
Dennis Seidenberg, Lucic turns, shoots. That was blocked by Douglas Murray. Just about blocked it with his face. Bergeron to Seidenberg. Chara can't get the shot, so he plays it around the outside. David Krejci, Bergeron bunts the puck back to Chara. He walks the line and passes off. Krejci's shot. Bocoon made the save, and Craig Adams gets to the rebound along the boards and clears it.
Maybe about 25 seconds from a real emotional boost for this building, and if I'm Dan Bylsma, come right back with your top players. You got to start generating some offense, get something going in the Boston zone.
Jágr. And perhaps the last rush of the power play. Marchand in front of the net. So is Lucic. Puck was knocked to the blue line. Ferentz. Jaromir Jágr as the crowd forms in front. Brad Marchand turns to his forehand against Paul Martin. Kennedy's over. Kennedy skates back on. Puck was held in by Ferentz. Off the boards and slapped in behind the net, and Brad Marchand comes up with it as the teams are at 5-on-5 now. Ferentz holds the puck in. Lucic off the boards trying to get control. Back in for Marchand. Spins away from a check and he spun himself into the ice. Jágr comes over to get the puck. Martin can't get inside on him. Lucic over to help. This looks like it's still on the power play for Boston. Andrew Ferentz. Brad Marchand tough to change, and the Penguins are tired. Jaromir Jágr cycles back again, and off the blue line, here comes Johnny Boychuk. Brad Marchand is backing him up, held the puck, and Tyler Kennedy stopped it and takes off the center. Boychuk trying to track him down. Dupuis is there as well for Pittsburgh. He gets checked by Milan Lucic. Fans react as the Penguins pass well. Dupuis got a pretty good hit. Here's Sean Thornton. Oh, a nifty little backhand that Bocoon had to stop, and this fourth line hasn't been able to get very much ice with all the special teams action. James Neal for Pittsburgh takes the shot. Rask makes the save and hangs on. Pascal Dupuis in a game with all sorts of big hits. Got one on Andrew Ferentz on Hockey Night in Canada at the Stanley Cup Playoffs. Building tonight in Pittsburgh, it's hard to find a quiet room, but Adam McQuaid spent a little time in there, and the tough Prince Edward Islander is back in the game.
Well, you look at the ice time on the back end with Chara already almost at the 15-minute mark. That pairing of Krug and McQuaid will get a chance to at least eat up some ice.
Malkin won a draw and gets the puck back from James Neal. Seidenberg comes at him and bounces off. A pass to the blue line. All Niskanen can do is hold the puck in for Pittsburgh. McKinley wanted the puck off the boards. Instead, James Neal played it back. And now Boston gets out to set. Here's Lucic with Bergeron and Krejci. Lucic, a giveaway. And here comes Malkin, forcing Chara to turn. Evgeny Malkin, drop pass. McKinley in his feet. What a save by Rask on James Neal, who is trailing the play. And back come the Bruins. Lucic trying to split the defense. Thornton follows him. Trying to feed David Krejci, and the Penguins don't spend any time in their end of the ice. Back quickly, Niskanen fires a shot. There's a rebound, bouncing puck, and Krejci cleared it to center. Could be a two-on-one. Here's Peverly with Sagan. The pass went off a skate and into the corner. Douglas Murray got back and had the puck hit him. Little tip through by Jerome McKinley as these teams go end-to-end again in the second period. Crosby's on the ice. He's with Jokinen and Chris Kunitz right now. Tyler Seguin up against Brooks Orpik. Chris Kelly on the forecheck. Stole the puck from Orpik. Bet Peverly and hit him in the skates. Rich Peverly with Seguin in front. Throws the puck to the net. Blocked by Kunitz. Up the boards. Jokinen got a break off the boards. Murray recovered to get the puck to center. Here's Jokinen. Crosby's with him. Kunitz shoots and he missed the net. And Pittsburgh's done a lot of that. Here's Peverly back to center with a shooting.
Boy, when you miss your chance offensively, though, you better get your mind turned to defense quickly, because both these teams, when there's one chance at the offensive end, the other team's just flying back trying to get one at the other on transition.
There's McQuaid back in action, fed the puck out to center. Mercer online, goes in after it. Mark Eaton is back. Paul Martin. Off the middle. Brandon Sutter turned back. Pittsburgh's trying to change here. Here comes Jaromir Jagr for Bergeron. Broken up by Paul Martin with a little help. And Tyler Kennedy dashes back the other way. A tip in by Sutter. McQuaid's got him lined up. Takes him into the boards and put the puck into an open corner. Torrey Krug is there. He's rubbed out by Brendan Morrow. Chris Letang for Pittsburgh trying to move back in. He's paired with Brooks Orpik right now. Orpik and Martin, usually the shutdown pair, split up, and Paul Martin's playing the left side. Here's a steal. And James Neal couldn't get away to get a shot. Letang was stripped to the puck. The Penguins recover. Here's Malkin. Morrow. Malkin with a tip through. Letang had gone too far. Malkin behind the net. Neal's out front. Off the boards. Morrow couldn't handle the puck, and now he's got a chase. Jaromir Jagr leading a 3-on-2. Broken up nicely by Chris Letang at the blue line. Neither team right now spending any time at all in their own zone.
You see Jagr when he made that bad pass. He just barely got that. Otherwise, it was an odd man rush going the other way. I'm sure he knew Julian wouldn't be liking that.
Malkin with three players on him. Took a slash, and it'll be a Boston penalty. And it's Milan Lucic with a slash into the hands of Evgeny Malkin. He was running into a crowd of Bruins. Boston penalized Pittsburgh for the power play when we come back. Nathan Horton gets the penalty here for a slash on Evgeny Malkin.
Well, Malkin sat for 5 minutes. He doesn't kill penalties, so he got on the ice. He wants to be a part of the game. Well, he's going to get a chance to be a part of the game because of that slash. He's on the power play. Time for the big boys to step up for Pittsburgh.
On average in these playoffs, Pittsburgh scored on every third power play. This is their third tonight. Malkin to the net, tries to save, rebound. Kunitz couldn't bury it off the post. James Neal knocked down, and the puck is cleared by Chris Kelly.
James Neal almost made that one possible. He got knocked down after the faceoff, but the puck hit him, and that's what created the chance.
Here's Kunitz. In on the wing, quick shot by Neal off the base of the post and into the corner. Neal tracks down the puck again, couldn't get it out front. Neal looks determined in this power play as the puck is sent down the ice. Kaye, look at him go, quickly in on Chris Letang, got the puck to Campbell. He was in too far to get a chance, short-handed, keeps the puck in. Kaye and Campbell. Nice looking penalty kill, and now they change. Gino leads the power play to center. 1-on-3. Gets in, gets set up. Tried to feed the puck back. Marchand knocked it down. Malkin recovered to keep it in. Here's Crosby. Kunitz out front. Pass didn't look like it was there. Here's a steal. Bergeron, a 2-on-0. Goes by himself. Bergeron beats. Can't finish. How is there not an interference penalty there?
You know what? If Letang stays on his feet and skates through him, he would have got it.
There's a tip just wide of the net. A 2-on-0. And Bergeron made the deke but couldn't finish. And back the other way comes Sidney Crosby. Dumps the puck in and Rask plays it along the boards. Rich Beverly to center. Paul Martin is there. Pittsburgh's changing on the fly. Still on the power play for another 20 seconds. And lucky that they're still in a 1-0 game. A bouncing puck cut by Aguila. Beverly gets it out to center. Aguila, you see Jokinen. Aguila wants the puck back. Jokinen goes to the other side. Paul Martin takes it off the boards. And the puck in. Aguila can't get a hold of it. He's checked. David Krejci to an open side, and the Bruins will get out to center. Nathan Horton out of the penalty box. Beverly feeds David Krejci. Niskanen comes at him, gets a piece of him, and the puck is chipped off the glass. Martin up the boards. Brendan Morrow got the puck to center. Dumped back in by Adam McQuaid on his second chance, and both teams are changing on the fly here.
Well, one thing Thomas Bolthoun has done well in this playoffs is handle breakaways. He did an excellent job in the Ottawa series stopping two big ones, and he tried a great poke check there with his stick to stop Bergeron from an empty net.
Always great in shootouts. Good practice for this situation as the puck is deflected and goes out of play with 6:14 to go in period number two. It's still a 1-0 game.
So much happening here. You see Marchand goes to get in the way. If Letang, instead of diving like that, just kept going. And I think there would have been a penalty, no question.
Okay, I'm not buying it. Because when you have a player who points, look at you take it, and he goes right at Letang.
Look at though, he didn't.
Sorry,
even,
it's a penalty.
It's astonishing it wasn't called.
Not if he dove there. I disagree with you on that one.
Good.
All Letang had to do is keep his progress going forward, and there would have been a penalty call. Stay on your feet.
Douglas Murray. Turned back by a pair of forecheckers. Fourth line for Boston on here. Torrey Krug to the open side. Gregory Campbell to the net. Bocun had to find the puck with a screen in front. Paye was right there. And he found it and the rebound was clear. Adam McQuaid to Torrey Krug. Wink wide, Gregory Campbell. Right there was Brooks Orpik and the puck is deflected over the glass and out of play. Chris Letang desperately trying to get back. Desperately angry that there was no penalty on Brad Marchand on Hockey Night in Canada. On the last Pittsburgh power play, great chances at both ends, a post and a poke.
Oh, it's the rust of the layoff. Pittsburgh has missed the net 9 times tonight. That's not even a shot on goal. And at the other end, watch the play by Vakun. Really smart. He can't get the puck, so he takes the stick of Bergeron. Otherwise, that would have been an easy tap-in putt.
And Glenn, as a player, again, you have to have in your mind that it's a right-handed catching goaltender. On most plays for Bergeron, that's an easy play around a glove. Instead, the stick was there, and he made an excellent move with it.
You're right, though, Simmer. This kid is not a kid anymore. He's great at breakaways.
36 years old. Had Bergeron scored there, I think we'd still be witnessing the argument.
Yeah, you bet. Would we ever. I think for Marchand, why not go in on a 2-on-0?
Well, yeah.
You took it away from your partner there, and I'm sure even Bergeron was a little surprised as he was probably going to be picking up a play with two of you.
He was fast enough to make it a 2-on-0.
I've never seen an eruption, but there was one on the Pittsburgh bench.
Oh, yeah. Here's Chris Kelly with a backhander that's blocked in the feet of Chris Letang. And the Penguins start out again. Letang has Kunitz in front of him. Crosby coming up late. And the play is stopped at the blue line.
With a SiriusXM radio, you can listen to a huge selection of channels free until June 3rd. Turn it on and hear what you've been missing. Visit SiriusXM.ca for details.
Smoking hot night in Pittsburgh, and outside where the Igloo, the old Mellon Arena, used to be, there's a big screen set up. Kind of neat, all the students from Duquesne University that's right around packed the furniture out of their rooms down there. There's couches and chairs.
Out our hotel window, boy, they were there at about 2:30 in the afternoon getting set up for an 8 o'clock start.
On a 30-degree day. And they're watching a heck of a game. Boston Bruins on the road to start this series ahead 1-0. 19-14 the shots for Pittsburgh. There's Tyler Kennedy. No Matt Cook on this line. Now Brendan Morrow out with Brandon Sutter. And the pass for Morrow got to the blue line. Martin with a shot. And Tuukka Rask very casually catches the puck and stops play.
One guy who has had a bit of a difficult night tonight has been Crosby. And, you know, here he is on the bench. It's him and Ginla. They're trying to work things out. It's tough when you've got to play against Chara. Shift in, shift out. Ginla, no shots. And Crosby, clearly very disappointed at the referee. Hey, I like face painters, but who dresses up like this? Obviously, that's why they stopped serving beer in another 421.
Might be a little warm in that costume tonight.
Honey, I'm going to wear this to the game.
And I'm not going with you.
How do you spell scalper?
Zdeno Chara. Dumps the puck in. Niskanen is back. He and Douglas Murray out against the third line for the Boston Bruins. Niskanen was spun around and knocked down by Peverly. Off the wing, Malkin stepped off the bench trying to dance. Chara got the puck to the net. Peverly. Tyler Seguin with Campbell coming up with him. Little counter hit by Niskanen. Hustling to the corner, Dan Paye. Johnny Boychuk takes the shot. Bocun somehow found that in traffic. And he makes the save.
Well, as if the Penguin fans need another reason to be upset with Chris Rooney or Brad Watson, they got another one as Niskanen coming around the net. Cleverly took his legs out. You hear a lot of groaning from the crowd at numerous plays. Watch Peverly, the stick gets right in between, gets caught up on the net, knocks Niskanen down. And then through a screen, a play in the corner where Ginla can't get his man. That's his point man, Boychuk. And the puck goes through. And look at Bokun look behind him for a split second, but a nice job working through the traffic.
Johnny Boychuk's got a great shot. He's got four playoff goals to lead this Boston defense that contributed 13 goals, most in the playoffs, seven against the Rangers. Without the defensemen scoring goals, they might not have got by the Rangers. Defenseman in the fourth line got the series for
him. Boychuk, you're right, he's got four, but he had gone 43 games in the regular season without getting a goal. And here has four in the first 11 games.
Big shift here, Crosby against the fourth line.
Thornton came in and won the draw. Even the wingers are winning the draws here for Boston. And Thornton has the puck. To Torrey Krug, he gets a shift against Sidney Crosby's line. And now he's going to change on the fly here after shooting the puck back in. Out to center, Kunitz. To Mark Eaton, puck got away from him. A turnover and Campbell can't take advantage. He just swats the puck in and Boston will change on the fly.
That was a break for Krug. Was supposed to change and didn't. He got caught there. He's had a little talk at the bench.
There's Sidney Crosby. Backhands the puck into Pascal Dupuis. Turns and shoots. Easy save. And now Brad Marchand starts out for Boston. Jágr with him. First round coming up late. Marchand with a nice move and a shot right on goal. And Bokun made a save on Jágr. You see Jokinen back the other way in the midst of a change. Dupuis straight up the middle. Feeds Chris Kunitz. Back to Jokinen. Nobody in front. The puck comes to the side of the net. Rask finds it and smothers it.
Now you see a lot of pushing and shoving after every whistle. You wonder if at some point just one guy is going to go. The Bruins, though, Marchand, a little outside, inside. Martin loses a step for a split second, but does a nice recovery and gets help from his partner. And then Bokun able to shut the door on Jaromír Jágr again.
Hasn't been as much traffic in front of Bokun as I thought there might be, but Pittsburgh hasn't been him in their own zone.
I was going to say, no sustained play. Most of it is just one and out, and then you're worried about getting back the other end defensively.
And they're pretty much the same at the other end, except when the power plays.
And Rask is the guy that I would be trying to get bumping and get bodies in front.
Make him mad.
He's got a worse temper than Glenn Healy.
At one point.
Another face-off win for Boston. Kelly got that one. And so the Bruins get out. Kelly was just out for the face-off. Switches off. The Krejci line is on the ice. There's Jussi Jokinen off the wing. And a Seidenberg blocked that pass. It was intended for Craig Adams. There's a steal by Brendan Morrow. Krejci comes at him. Craig Adams checked by Krejci. He shoveled the puck to Horton. Two on two, starting out with Lucic. Decides to dump the puck in and go after it against Brooke Norton. Horton took the hit. Lucic comes in and gets the puck. David Krejci. Adam McQuaid on the other side. Here's Krug. Will he get his shot through? Now he takes it. Deflects. Well, Krug made the save. A deflection right on, and Krug does find a way to get that puck to the net. And Pittsburgh's forced to ice the puck with a minute 36 left in this period.
Well, there's one example of a little bit of sustained play and all kinds of action in front of Bokun, but a nice job of the Penguin defense. You think of the fourth line type shift, but Orpik boxes out. Look at the laneway available for Bokun. And an anxious moment as that hit Adams to the side, but Bokun with a great reaction to get the pad down. A
double deflection.
Timeout Pittsburgh now as a tired group.
Timeout Pittsburgh.
Yeah, in a tight game like this, it's tough to use your timeout with a minute 36 left in the second, but Dan Bylsma felt he needed it because he'd been dominated so badly on faceoffs.
And fourth line out. Too long. And what he needs to get on more is Crosby. And Crosby tonight, it has been a night of difficulties for him at times. It started well, hits the post, face-off percentage has not been good. He wins that one, but he's just north of 30%. Char's been all over him. That's normally in. Never takes penalties. He took a penalty. Smart play here to move a stick on a power play. Blue line got him there. Sniper in the third row. So guys like Crosby with 21:36 left to play in this game, if it doesn't go to overtime, you never know when he can turn it on in a flash.
You got to wonder, too, without the protective face shield, whether that has any kind of an influence at all on maybe a little bit more tentative in this game. We'll see.
Timeout complete. Jokinen did a nice job. It's maybe what Pittsburgh needs to do more of, just tie up on the faceoff and get a winger win. And Pittsburgh got the draw, got the puck down the ice, and they get their change. Douglas Murray couldn't get the puck at the blue line to hold it in. Niskanen couldn't dump it in. Crosby's on the ice. Slow change at the Pittsburgh bench. They had four guys on the ice, and Crosby was all on his own. Malkin and Neal have come out with him here for a late shift. James Neal, Evgeny Malkin spins away from a check. Into Crosby, Torrey Krug on the ice against Crosby, and Malkin got the puck up the boards. Bergeron following Sagan, lifts it out to center. Peverly ran into Neal. Now Malkin.
I'm surprised Julian got caught with that, Jim, at the end of the period with Krug now having to play against that top Pittsburgh line.
Maybe that's why Pittsburgh was so slow to get the
quickly
change.
To get the change.
They loaded up the line when they saw they had a matchup they didn't like. And now another Pittsburgh player hit hard along the boards. It's James Neal. And there's a penalty on the play.
Well, you saw Cook go for a hit from behind Marchand, another hated Bruin, as the crowd and the discussion between the officials, what is the call?
How serious will this one be as Brad Marchand goes to the penalty box for the hit on Neal?
2 minutes for roughing is the only call. Neal gets up.
You can hear what the fans think of that call.
Yeah, dusts himself off. This is a play where Neal gets hit from behind. Marchand doesn't like the look of it. And Neal's got an opportunity to make the play, and there's the push from behind, and Neal goes in. No body on body through, but definitely on the numbers. What's the talk down there?
The talk is that it's the exact same hit as was on McQuaid that led to a 5-minute knee.
So nobody likes this. But Boston doesn't even think it's a penalty. Pittsburgh power play with 30 seconds to go in the second period. They finally got a draw. Sidney Crosby to Chris Kunitz. Neal's in front. The pass. Chris Letang passes off. Malkin with the post. Rebound to the side of the net. Rass stuck his stick out. Puck is still loose as they barge in there. Kunitz tried to wheel it into the net. Chris Letang. Sidney Crosby. Neal shoots. Stopped by Rass. Here's Malkin. Goes wide on Peverly. Snoop the puck to the side of the net. And Rass has got it with 5 seconds to go in the period.
You talk about surviving an onslaught. Tuukka Rask just taking a little skate. We got a couple of unbelievable breaks. What a quick passing play that ends up with a one-timer through a screen right off the post. Scramble in front, loose puck. Look at the bodies in front. Chara trying not to put his hand on it. Campbell can't clear it. And then a positional save by Rask that he didn't even see. Just got him right on the shoulder.
This is the shot by Malkin. And you can see what happens for a Pittsburgh team that hadn't been able to win a faceoff all night. They finally got one, and look what happened.
I think you're going to take one out of this scrum.
Yeah,
it's going to be Kunitz.
Well, Kunitz and Peverly.
Yeah, it looks like Peverly's going as well.
Kunitz and Peverly were the main combatants by the end of it. And they're both headed to the dressing room.
You really do take for granted the faceoff importance, don't you, as Chara and Crosby have words.
Gotta love it. This is only game one.
Yeah, we're not even in the third period yet. You just expect it to happen.
Size difference is so noticeable between Crosby and Chara.
Now, what could that be about?
Even when he bends down and puts his
let me get down
stick
so
on his knees. Yeah, exactly.
I want to hear you right.
Put
so
the giraffe going to get water.
Bruins get a hold of the puck on a scramble draw. Chop it out to center to end the period. There's still a minute and a half on the power play, and there's still more of a brouhaha going at center.
Crosby's going after Rask, too, at the rim.
And Evgeny Malkin is in a scrap.
Well, if he's going to take a guy, that's a good guy to take. Tough trade-off, and I'm not sure Bergeron doesn't have his jersey tied down.
Bergeron and Malkin, and Bergeron's on the bottom of this, and Crosby and Chara are really at each other.
I have not seen Crosby this upset in a game ever. And he basically had the blade of his stick by the chin of Chara after he cross-checked Rask, as you mentioned, Simmer.
So he's trying to get Rask, who's been known to be a bit of a hothead, he's trying to get him to take the bait, and he wouldn't. Then he went after Chara, and Malkin fought Bergeron.
Well, both took a few shots before they dropped the gloves. Here's the play of Crosby going at Rask. He comes, gives him a little shot there. Must have been a little stick action. He comes right back to him and gives him a chop. What action. Chara coming back into the fold as well. All that happening while the fight just began.
Man, there's been a lot of stuff going on in this game through the two periods. All over the ice. And Bergeron and Malkin decide to drop the gloves and start chucking them. So they'll be gone for a while in the early part of the third period, but Pittsburgh won't have Malkin for the power play. Boston won't have Bergeron for the penalty kill and for the faceoffs. The Crew at 42 and the hot stove coming up. Lots to discuss around the league and in this game. A 1-0 lead for the Bruins on the road on Hockey Night in Canada.
Bruins leading 1-0 to start the third period here at the CONSOL Energy Center in Pittsburgh. What a turn of events to finish the second. Evgeny Malkin in a fight. Sidney Crosby frustrated. Nothing good can come of either for the Penguins, although assistant coach Todd Reardon says the Penguins have no problem with Malkin standing up for himself. He says Pittsburgh's not unhappy with its scoring chances. Two posts in the first, hit two more in the second, but there's still a premium on hitting the Boston net more in the final 20 minutes of regulation, Jim.
So the Penguins start this third period with a minute and 31 seconds on the power play. No Malkin on the power play, no Bergeron, but the Bruins are deep at center, and Gregory Campbell won the opening faceoff of period number three. Boston has won 65% of the draws. Chris Letang to center. Crosby to Jerome McGinley out there with James Neal on the power play and Brendan Morrill. Loose puck side of the net. Crosby feeds it back. Here's Letang into the middle of the ice. No one-timer there for Aguila. Back to Letang. This time Jerome takes the shot. It's blocked by Dennis Seidenberg. And Zdeno Chara got the loose puck. He's already played 20 minutes in the game, and he moved the puck down the ice.
A poor choice of shot by Aguila there. He's off balance, one-timer from way out.
Letang to Morrill on the other side. Aguila again. Return pass from James Neal. Neal again heads to the net, centering pass. Shot just wide by Brendan Morrill. And Dennis Seidenberg gets to the puck and gets it down the ice into the last 30 seconds of the penalty to Brad Marchand called late in that second period. Here comes Sid. Picks up speed. Backhander. Rask to save. Rebound. Jussi Jokinen got to it, then gave it away. And Gregory Campbell gets out to center to Dan Pailler. One man back. Paille against Letang takes the backhander that Volkoon stops easily. Quickly up ice, running out of time in the power play. Here comes Tyler Kennedy with his shot that goes off the stick of Chara, and then Kennedy went heavily into the end boards as the puck left the playing surface and the penalty's over.
Well, another different look at the power play because of Malkin in the box, and again was wanting the one-timer, but look at it, he's a little off balance and he forces it from far away. And then Morrow in front, he's got himself a position, kicks off and gets a good chance.
Sidney Crosby, incredible burst of speed. Pittsburgh Penguins stretch a guy to that left D on the blue line. That opens up a right side entry for Pittsburgh almost every time. The shift before, it was Morrow there, Chara has to back off, and they enter with a good stretch pass.
Boston won another draw, so they were able to get out through center, get out of their own zone, get a change, and now they're into the attacking zone. Krug with a shot, just dumping the puck into the corner. Adam McQuaid comes off the blue line, bites off Pascal Dupuis. It stays in deep. David Krejci's there. Krug thought about coming in off the blue line. Now he backs up defensively because he's might have been in a little trouble. And he had Milan Lucic on the other side. There's Brandon Sutter. Moves in on McQuaid. Takes the hit, trying to stay on the puck. Krejci came back, center in support to help out. Pascal Dupuis in behind the net. Connor Kennedy. Dupuis fed the puck out front. Lucic is there to take it away. Nathan Horton dumps the puck in. Boston changes on the fly again. And a delayed offside here as Gregory Campbell got in and touched the puck.
Well, we talked about game plan coming in and what the matchups would be, and strictly Claude Julien's been able to get most of what he's wanted with Chara against Crosby and Malkin. And you think of all the power play time and penalty killing time, Chara is going to get that ice time.
Well, technology is at its finest. You can watch your shift after you get off the ice. There's Crosby and Neil watching their shift on an iPad. Okay, here's how we can get better at next shift. We had those when we played.
I was going to say the game's changed a little bit, hasn't it?
You're lucky to have an assistant coach.
Did you have colored chalk? Here's Gregory Campbell trying to feed the puck in front. There was a two-on-one. Jaromir Jagr. Gregory Campbell tried to hook the puck in front, couldn't do it. Douglas Murray. Racing in is Andrew Ferris against Craig Adams. Well-timed pinch of the Bruins keep the puck in. Jagr, Campbell. There's Marchand. They'll go back the other way. That's what the Bruins are looking for, some sustained time on their cycle. And they force Pittsburgh to ice the puck. And that's a tired line, and Pittsburgh doesn't have a timeout.
Now you'll see a very quick change by the Bruins trying to get themselves an opportunity here to win and yet another draw. 66% on the night. Jokinen coming in here trying to win one.
The guy I'd be worried about is Douglas Murray. Not great foot speed, and when you're tired, less foot speed.
Boston wins the draw again, so deep at center. Chara shot the puck wide of the net. Fed to the front of the goal by Peverly. And there was Jussi Jokinen to try and clear it. Can't get it out. Held in by Chris Kelly. Another attempt to get out, and Chara held the puck in. There's Murray under pressure from Sagan, who goes right at him. So on the other side, Niskanen will try and get out. They put the puck by Adams. It went all the way down the ice and right on goal, and there's no icing. And Pittsburgh finally gets a change. Beverly shot the puck in. First man back is Mark Eaton. He's under pressure. Horton came right at him. To David Krejci. Shoots. Hope doing the save. Can't find the rebound. Krejci scores. Bocoon couldn't find it, but Krejci stayed with it. And Krejci's got his second goal of the game. 2-0 Boston.
Well, in the corner, Mark Eaton's doing circles, just looking up at the skies. He knows he wasn't able to make a play that ends up costing his team. He's on the boards there, loses the battle for the loose puck. Horton out battles him. Watch the puck in the air. I think Letang hits it out of the air. It comes right down on the stick of David Krejci. That's Letang 58.
I think what you have to do here is after Krejci shoots the puck, you take Krejci.
Yeah.
Let Bakun worry about finding the puck.
So not only did he knock the puck out of the air, but he runs into his goaltender.
Yeah.
And this
double
is
whammy.
A rare night where you get the Crosby line minus two.
And once again, it's David Krejci's line. In this series, as they were against Toronto, leading the way, Horton will get an assist. They've each got a couple of points, and Boston has a 2-0 lead. Here they are, four checkers. Horton, Krejci, and Lucic, they just come on the ice, so they're fresh and they stay. For the shift after the goal, Boychuk with his shot, that was blocked. Ferentz holds the puck in, and Brandon Sutter quickly clears it to center. Joel McKinley and James Neal out here with Brandon Sutter. All sorts of different line combos since Matt Cook's out of the game, and Malkin sitting in the penalty box. Lucic, Krejci to the front of the net. Bokun clears that. And back to the puck is James Neal. His outlet to center. No gap there as Ferentz stayed up on a Ginla. Back in comes Marchand. He overskated the puck. Sidney Crosby stole it from Gregory Campbell. 2-on-2. Crosby looks around, drop pass. Letang to the net. Can't get the shot. But Ginla did, and Rask stopped it. Another pile up in the corner, and the puck is still loose. Letang stays in deep. Gets the puck, tried to feed it to the front of the net. Seidenberg cleared it. Gregory Campbell dives. He's dead tired. He's just trying to advance the puck. Letang back the other way. A rink-wide pass. Kunitz came off the bench and got the puck to Crosby. Hard around for Chris Letang. Slipped the check from Marchand. They're backing up the play with Chara, and he helped get it to center. Here's Tyler Seguin. On his own, his mates are changing. Pascal Dupuis comes over at him. Both two out to play the puck. Matt Niskanen. Everly comes after him. Penguins out to center. Crosby's still on. Dupuis drives wide. Backhander towards the net off the stick. Stays in play. Chris Kelly tips up the boards and gets the puck out. Seguin hustled to it, but he couldn't get control. Matt Niskanen. The center. Penguins just dumped the puck in. Crosby's been out there for a while. Torrey Krug is back. Brendan Morrow and Dupuis come crashing into the Bruins. Come out of the corner with the puck.
The longer this goes without a whistle, guys, Malkin can't escape jail. He's sitting waiting. This is now almost a 7-minute penalty for him because of no whistles.
Bruins are so deep at center that they haven't really missed Bergeron because they've still won all the faceoffs where Pittsburgh needs a goal and they badly need Malkin. Ferentz turned the puck to center. Haye with a shoot in. Bokun quickly clears it. You see Jokinen. Required to Tyler Kennedy. Speedster can back up the defense and he gets a shot that Rask stopped.
There's a play there where Bokun should have noticed that and grabbed that and taken a whistle. Now he's going to get a whistle there. At least Malkin can get off now.
And Orpik touches the puck. The Bruins have iced it. And Bergeron and Malkin are released with 12:50 to go in the third period. Boston up 2-0.
Different body language by both players in the penalty box. It was Malkin who spent 3 minutes standing up watching going, get me out there. I need a whistle. I want to play. Bergeron, the vet that he is, sitting comfortably down in the penalty box.
Yeah, now when this whistle goes, I'll get up and make my way onto the ice.
Tick, tick,
there's Bergeron.
Tick,
right? Yeah. Ho-hum.
Roll McGinley to take the faceoff instead of Malkin, but the Bruins gained the puck and they got it again. Even when the centerman doesn't win it cleanly, they're winning the draws. And they might have to win another one here in their own end as they've iced the puck again.
Well, one big challenge for the Penguins here against this Bruin team is just they haven't been able to get that sustained pressure. They haven't been able to keep the cycle down low. The effective plays that they have with Crosby and Malkin behind the net really forcing Rask to look around his shoulders. Boston's done a pretty nice job of breaking those cycles up. It's been more of a transition game all night.
Malkin against Krejci this time. And David Krejci wins the draw. Off the board, Taye couldn't get the puck out against Letang. But three Bruins are there, and they get the puck to center. Letang watched by Krejci. Oh, he's going to change, so Pittsburgh has the puck. Neal just about turned it over to Nathan Horton. Niskanen can't get by Lucic, a neutral zone turnover. Gregory Campbell up the middle. Here's Horton, takes the shot. That went off Niskanen into the corner. Campbell in front of the net, and a tap in for Nathan Horton to make it 3-0. An open net, and Boston has a comfortable 3-0 lead.
Same story, same line as Marc-Andre Fleury looks on. Nathan Horton, right place at the right time. This line, though, eating up. It's neutral zone turnovers, so costly. We've talked transition all game. You can see Campbell now gets in the action as he's at the end of his shift. He just throws it to the net. Look at all the Penguins puck watching. That's been a real problem. The first goal was very much three Penguins in the corner, two Boston Bruins all by themselves in front of the goaltender.
Should Bokun have been able to corral that instead of having it go off into Horton?
You got to know the player is there, so treat that shot slash pass
like a shot deflected out of harm's way. But that was off of an icing. So that shouldn't be the result when Boston really wanted to change.
Almost thinking about taking a timeout, weren't they?
Boston, totally. And I put Flurry in.
Just to get him some action?
Absolutely.
Yeah, get his mind into it?
You're going to have to go to him at some point. And he likes playing at home. He likes playing in front of this crowd.
And this crowd needs something to get them back into the game because it's gone pretty quiet here. That's Horton from Campbell and Lucic at 7:51. Horton's got a goal and two tonight. He continues a magnificent spring run. Another neutral zone turnover. Tyler Kennedy for Pittsburgh dumps the puck in. 6 points for Krejci, Lucic, and Horton. And a 3-0 lead for Boston on the road in game one of the Eastern Conference Finals. Sid's back on and has the puck. Little drop pass for Kunitz. Puts it to the net, tipped by Dupuis. Crosby shoots and Rask got across to make the save. And Mark Eaton backs up into his own zone as Boston's changes come quickly now. Dupuis, Kunitz, poke check by Tuukka Rask. And his lines come close, but they can't finish. Here's Mark Eaton on the other side. Chris Letang, Sidney Crosby, backhand pass in front of the net. Dupuis couldn't shoot it before Johnny Boychuk cleared it. Here's Paille for Campbell just out of his reach. And he threw the puck at the net again. Why not? Worked the last time. Here's Paille. Zdeno Chara takes the shot. Bukun the save. Rebound. Thornton couldn't bury it. How much did Bruins trust their fourth line playing against Crosby and Malkin and hitting in their own zone?
Yeah, Crosby has taken a couple of good whacks at Sean Thornton, too. It's been a frustrating night for number 87 as he had that great chance that couldn't find the back of the net on Tuukka Rask.
Milan Lucic is shooting from center. We passed the midway mark of the third period. Krejci and Horton have scored for Boston in this third to make it 3-0. Ball mark just about gave the puck away to Horton. Seidenberg takes the man. Malkin and the puck goes in deep. Chara up the boards to Lucic, a 3-on-2 breakout for Boston. Krejci with a give and go, and the shot from Lucic goes over the net and comes all the way back into the Bruins' zone. Ferentz is back. Beats the forecheck to get the puck to Lucic, and he shoots it in. Another quick change here for Boston.
We're seeing a lot of that from Boston now. Just get over the line and get it in and just keep forcing the Penguins to go through five guys in the neutral zone. Like that.
Like that. Here's Brooks Orpik. Threw the puck to the front of the net. Good stick there by Rask. Block the pass and his teammates get the puck to the blue line no further. Marchand with a second chance got it up. Matt Niskanen has the puck. Douglas Murray dumps it in. Rask is out to play it. He's pretty good at that as he moves the puck up the boards. Marchand gave it away in the middle. Here's a chance for Tyler Kennedy, and he was checked. And the puck came out over the blue line and went back in as the play is stopped offside. 3-0 lead for the Bruins, and the Penguins have had some chances. Here's Crosby with an open net. He sort of missed the shot. But Rask got across and made the save. And Nathan Horton hits the net can. Tuukka Rask has been excellent tonight. He's had a little help because of that.
Sound of the pipes. I love it. Boston has not won a playoff game in Pittsburgh since April 13th, 1980. And this is one of the reasons why they will win tonight. Three posts. Crosby, Kunitz, Malkin.
And even more recently, Boston has lost six of the last seven games they've played against Pittsburgh. But they've played a very good game tonight. And the Penguins have come unglued. And they're behind 3-0. Still with a little time left if they get one now. But they've got the firepower to come back.
What's amazing for Boston is that their offense has woken back up. They finished the year with 2 goals, 4 or less in 8 of 9. Now in this game, that's 9 of 13. The last 13, they've scored at least 3.
Martin trips and falls. Here's Kelly, 2-on-1. Peverly's out front. Chris Kelly to the net. The rebound off of Okun. Peverly turns. Feeds the puck back to the blue line. Seidenberg off the wing. The shot from Thornton went up in the air over top of Okun to the end boards or to the middle of the ice. And Chara dumps it back in. Boston changing again. And just hanging out in the neutral zone. Lucic, the only forechecker here, trying to force the direction. Brooks pick up the middle. Has to play the puck across to try and beat this trap, and Malkin can't do it.
One thing about the Bruins is they have such continuity in the zone. I mean, the first forechecker does a nice job taking away speed, and then you can see all the options seem to be gone, forcing either a turnover or a dumping.
And that's what they had there, so Seidenberg is back to get the shoot-in. To Nathan Horton at center to the open wing. Krejci abandons and heads for the bench on a chain. James Neal for Jerome McKinley. Now with Brandon Sutter. They go around the outside. Douglas Murray with his shot. Knocked down in front of the net very calmly by Tori Krug. He fed the puck out to Paille. He's got Niskanen in a little trouble. Niskanen recovered to get the puck to the end boards. Gregory Campbell. Back to get the puck is Tyler Kennedy. And again, the Bruins clog up the neutral zone. Brandon Sutter with Kennedy. Gets the puck deep. Ferris chases him. Morrow came in and couldn't get the puck. Fed back to the blue line. Niskanen with a shot. It's blocked in front of the net. Sutter turned and shot. And he fanned on it. And John Thornton moves the puck through the neutral zone as Boston plays its third, fourth line as much as they have at any time in the game because there haven't been penalties here lately. Seidenberg took a hit and moved the puck along the boards. Patrice Bergeron against Crosby. Out for Lucic, a bouncing puck. Martin is there. Dupuis comes back for Pittsburgh.
Also been able to keep the minutes down of Chara, too, the way this game sure went. Because early on, he was 11 minutes in the first period, only 8-plus in the second, and now he's just at almost 24 minutes for the game.
And the Bruins are just chewing up minutes.
Keep the puck going. Keep everything going forward. Don't turn it over. And don't give the Penguins any speed through the neutral zone.
Chara's on the ice now as Kunitz moves in, stops up, feeds the puck across. It was deflected to Crosby. Chara comes right at him. Crosby gets loose and he fed the puck up the middle, and that's the kind of night it's been for Sid, a frustrating one as he split his own defensive pair trying to feed the point. Chris Letang. Malkin. The drop pass and the play's offside. 4:44 to go in the third period. Our hockey night close-up. Sid and Zdeno meet again on close-up after this break on Hockey Night in Time now for the Hockey Night close-up brought to you by Subway Restaurants, and it features Sid and Zdeno.
Well, it's the tale of two cities and the tale of two stars, and it has not been a good night for Sidney Crosby and the Pittsburgh Penguins. Played a lot of minutes tonight and a whopping minus two. He even got grass to get underneath his skin. The Stars have fought Malkin a fight. I've never seen that. And again, Chara and Crosby, 13 shifts against each other. Chara's winning that with a plus two.
Boston ahead in the first game of the Eastern Conference Final, 3-0. 4.5 minutes to go, and in the attacking zone again. Gregory Campbell's centering pass was picked off, but he got the puck back, threw it out front. Paille couldn't get it. The fourth liners in a 3-0 game get a chance to give the top players a little bit of rest.
Yeah, it's just so important, and the confidence factor for Claude Julien that he has with this group. And how about Tori Krug, too? I mean, that's a tough decision for the head coach, putting Krug in a game like this on the road against a tough offensive team. And for the most part, Krug really showed what he does add to that lineup, that ability to move the puck and make some plays.
He did protect him a little bit. He tries to play him against the third or fourth line, but in a game with so few stoppages early on, he couldn't completely protect him. There's Rask making a save as Aguila attacked the net. Douglas Murray fanned on an attempt to keep the puck in. Lucic couldn't make the play in the neutral zone, but the Bruins have the puck anyway. outside.
Pittsburgh to Lucic.
Pittsburgh would tell you they gave him a free pass. Where's the forecheck?
Yeah, AG to Chara, who shot one off a skate.
As we said, we thought that would be a matchup early on that maybe Dan Bosma could take advantage of, but it hasn't materialized.
Another chance for Horton. He was stopped. And the Penguins look like they quit playing right now.
And that line, that Krejci line really has it going again, doesn't it? Much like the first round. Not nearly as effective in round two, but against the Leafs, especially early, they dominated.
6 points tonight, 2 goals for Krejci, 1 for Horton. The depth of the Bruins, if that line's not going, you might get it from Bergeron's line. You get 13 goals from the defense.
Well, how about game winners from Campbell
and Paille?
Paille in game 3 and 5 off the fourth line, exactly.
Pittsburgh in its last 2 games of the Ottawa series scored 6 goals and 7 goals, and they can't get one tonight. Leading the playoffs by a mile in goals scored, scoring at a pace equivalent to the 1990 Edmonton Oilers. But unable to get anything on Tukarask tonight so far, and they're down to their last couple of minutes.
Glenn, I ask you, what do you do with Volkoon? You can't really pin this one on him at all. But you mentioned you would have put Fleury in.
Dupuis with a shot, and Rask made a nice save.
I think you think long and hard about it for game two.
At home might give the team a boost. There's another chance, and Volkoon makes the save, this time on Rich Peverly, with 1:50 to go in the third period. Is going to be
another frustrating penalty.
Another penalty. And it is frustration. Sidney Crosby's been talking to the referee since the very start of the game.
That's not often you see that. I mean, typically handles that fairly well. And right off the bat, it's been frustrating. Beast thought he got a stick in the face and the top of the helmet, and instead he gets called.
Here's his mindset, though. Okay, this is Sidney Crosby, best player in the world. This is the almost flying left elbow. That's not the way Crosby plays. And he hasn't had a good night against Marchand. We know he's a super pest, but it's whistle the whistle. You got to play.
You drew the comparison to that Philadelphia-Pittsburgh series last season. I think that's a good one in the first game, and Pittsburgh better.
Boy, if I'm Dan Bosma, I want to eliminate that, don't
you? Absolutely.
We don't want anything to mirror that.
Just play. Don't lose your cool.
That's what the Bruins pride themselves on, though, that pack mentality. And they are a frustrating team to play against.
Look who's on the power play.
Yeah. Says a lot.
Thornton, Campbell, and Paille off the fourth line. Andrew Ferentz. Johnny Boychuk, the big boys all sit down. Tori Krug got it. Oops. Recover to get the puck to Seidenberg. Brad Marchand.
1 minute.
Now with Bergeron and Jágr. Got to center, no further. Brendan Morrow sent the puck back into the Boston zone. We're in the last minute of the third period, and a lot of the people that were here for the 285th consecutive sellout have packed it in. Game two in this series is Monday night, 8 Eastern time. We'll be on the air at 7:30 with Scotiabank Hockey tonight on Hockey Night in Canada.
And how about Tuukka Rask? Pretty solid game in nets for him. And an opportunity to, hate to say it, but 30 seconds left to get his first playoff shutout.
The Pittsburgh had tilted the game a little bit in the shots on goal department, but Boston's come back and now they've outshot Pittsburgh 30-29. Good third period. Krejci and Horton scored 3 minutes apart.
Lendy has sensed that frustration all the way through on that Pittsburgh bench, though.
To a man,
yeah,
on that bench. It's you've got to rework your emotions for a new series against a different team. And I think everybody thought that they were starting Thursday. And so how do you work your bench? How do you work your practice?
There's another post, this time for the Bruins. Boychuk stick broke.
But clearly their game plan was not so.
Well, now they're not starting Thursday or Saturday for Pittsburgh. The series starts on Monday. Game over. Tuukka Rask has his first ever playoff shutout. A 29 save performance with the help of a couple of posts, and the Boston Bruins strike first in the Eastern Conference Final with a 3-0 victory.
And still the discussion continues for the Penguin captain. He's showing the evidence on his visor of the high stick he took before the penalty he took. 3-0, basically a moot point.
One last message before he leaves. Will we see Vaucun out, Marc-Andre Fleury in? We know Tuukka Rask will be back on Monday night for game 2. Bruins lead the series 1-0. Ron, back to you.